interested in how you got to the point to writing this and why you chose this topic. But then you told us how you discovered Mary Bowser. And I don't remember what I was
going to answer. So she asked me before I started, I said, well, you know, I was working on my specialty was African American literature. And that's what you said, why did you choose that specialty? And I will say that I'm of an age that when I went to college, I was really excited to read what feminists were writing. And it was very energizing to me. But there were a lot of black women, Bell Hooks, June Jordan, Barbara Christian, I can name names on and on, who were saying, you know, white women who want to talk about gender, you have to also talk about race and class, because we can't just talk about one of those things without talking about all of them. And so when I started doing my graduate work, I was really trying to honor that charge, because I think it's absolutely true. Now, I will tell you, like I said, I think Frederick Douglass is one of the greatest American writers. Reading Gwendolyn Brooks' poetry and teaching Gwendolyn Brooks' poetry is not a sacrifice. That I never felt like I had to do it. And it was, you know, because it had to be done, because it was a responsibility, I felt like that charge gave me a way to fall in love with an amazing body of literature that is powerful and moving and as good as Shakespeare and as good as Walt Whitman and as good as anything anybody can study in any classroom. And I think that it is really important for that not to just be something that, as hard as it is, the woman who said, you know, black kids still aren't learning this history or this literature, it's not just that black kids need to learn it, we all need to learn it. And I think that that's really a great part. And again, it's not a sacrifice, it's a beautiful life.